Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. I want to proceed the lecture for chapter 5 for oscillator circuit. Okay, so this is the part 2 for the chapter 5. Okay, objective for this chapter is first to know the basic concept of oscillator and then to know the basic principle of operation of oscillator. Okay, we will see a bit about RC and LC feedback oscillator. Okay, and then we will see the operation of the basic relaxation oscillator and principle of VCO, 555 timer and PPL. Okay, PPL, you will read yourself lah. Okay, so this is the difference between negative feedback and positive feedback. So, positive feedback is the oscillator and negative feedback is the op-amp actually, okay. So, the feedback signal is opposite polarity, okay, has self-correcting ability against any changes. It degenerate or reduce output voltage and mostly used in amplifier lah. It mentioned here amplifier. And for positive feedbacks, okay, or oscillator, okay, the feedback signal is of the same polarity or in phase with input signal. A portion of the output voltage of an amplifier is feedback with no net phase shift, resulting in a reinforcement of the output signal. And the feedback signal is the input signal regenerative feedback. So it is necessary in oscillator circuit. So this is the oscillator circuit lah. Okay. So oscillator is the circuit that produces repetitive waveform. Okay, and its output is a DC voltage as an input. Okay, so DC voltage maksudnya DC lah. Awak punya input ialah DC. Okay, so DC. Straight line eh. Okay, in some oscillator, output signal can be generated even without a necessary input signal. Okay, without input signal. Selalunya ini dia akan jadi awak punya VCC lah. Okay. So, tak semestinya ada input pun boleh jadi oscillator jugalah. Okay. So, important application is to waveform generation, frequency amplitude. And output oscillator can be either sinusoidal or non-sinusoidal. So, ni dia punya type. Type oscillator ada dua, sinusoidal dengan non-sinusoidal. Sinusoidal ialah sin, cosine, okay, non-sinusoidal, triangular wave, rectangular wave, okay, ataupun dua ni lah. So, two major classification of oscillator is feedback oscillator and relaxation oscillator. Ada dua, okay. So, feedback oscillator ni memang oscillator lah, okay, relaxation oscillator. So, selalunya oscillator ni apa? Awak punya apa? Signal generator. Okay. Dia punya application is signal generator lah yang dekat lab tu. Okay. So, this is the feedback oscillator. Okay. So, dia sama lebih kurang macam feedback juga. Dia ada A. Amplifier. Dan dia ada B. Beta. Tapi, dekat sini mixer dia mesti positif, positif. Baru dia boleh jadi feedback feedback oscillator lah. Okay, widely used to generate sinusoidal waveform. Feedback oscillator return a fraction of the output signal to the input V output over VI. With no net phase shift, resulting a reinforcement of the output signal. So, dia punya input macam tu, output dia pun macam tu juga. Okay, after oscillation are started, the loop gain is maintained at 1 to maintain oscillation. Okay, so kita nak maintain oscillation sama je, A mesti sama dengan 1. Okay, so the feedback oscillation consists of amplifier for gain, either discrete transistor or M, and a positive feedback circuit that produce phase shift and provide attenuation. Okay, so ni ialah syarat. This is how the oscillation happen. So ni input, bila masuk dekat amplifier jadi besar. Okay, and then dia pergi kat feedback. Okay, pergi dekat B, feedback. And then jadi kecil balik dan dia akan circulate. So ni dia maintain lah. Kalau awak tengok dia akan continuously ulang aja. Okay, ulang aja. Yang ni kalau negatif lah. Okay, tapi dia punya output still positif. Okay. So, the increased feedback voltage, VF, is amplified to produce the feedback voltage. So, ni operation dia lah. Okay. A loop is created in which the signal sustains itself and a continuous sinusoidal output is produced. This is called oscillation. Oscillation, maksudnya dia beralun. Okay. The feedback circuit shift, the phase 180 and invert amplifier is required to provide another 180 phase shift so that there is no net phase shift. Okay. Dia tak nak berubah. Bila kat sini dia control 180, dia tak nak berubahkan this one dia positive cycle kan. Dia nak maintain, nak tukar dia jadi. Ni baliklah. Okay. Same with here. Okay, ni condition for oscillation. Okay, ni soalan final lah ni. Selalu-selalu tanya soalan final. Nombor satu, the phase shift around the feedback loop must be effectively zero. Okay. And number two, the voltage gain around the closed feedback loop gain must be equal to one. Dia ada dua. Phase shift, zero, ACL, one. And you must draw this circuit. Okay, to final. So you have to draw lah. Okay, the diagram. So start up. To start pula, kita nak start oscillate tu, ACL must be greater than 1. Okay, and gain must be decreased to 1. Is equal to 1 jugalah. So, the output stay to the desired level. Okay. So, ada dua condition. The first one is startup condition. The second one is condition for oscillation. So, dua-dua ni penting lah. Okay, untuk menghasilkan oscillator. So, if there is no DC voltage, maksudnya tak ada input how does the feedback signal originate to start positive feedback? So, dia akan datang daripada internal internal produce broadband noise kat dalam lah internal punya small positive feedback. So, dia akan permit only a voltage with frequency equal to the selected oscillation frequency and then dia akan amplify and continue enforce and result the output voltage. So, itu ialah operation daripada slide number 5 sampai 9. Okay. So, ada dua jenis feedback oscillator. Either RC or LC. So, ada banyak ni. Okay. Wind bridge, phase shift, twin T. So, ni dalam feedback ni ada R dengan C je. Resistor, kapasitor. Untuk yang ni dia ada LC je. Inductor dengan kapasitor. Okay. So, this one is for RC is for frequency up to 1 MHz. So, depends what frequency you want to oscillate. And for LC, for frequency more than 1 MHz. Okay. So, untuk RC, kita ada wind bridge, phase shift, twin T. LC, kita ada Colpitts, clap, Hartley, Armstrong dan crystal control. Okay. So, for your information, you can go through this type of RC and LC by yourself. Okay, by reading it. Okay, because I think there will be no in final exam lah. Okay, so this one is wind bridge. Okay, dia panggil wind bridge sebab dia ada kaki bridge ni. Consists of non-inverting amplifier and two RC network. Voltage divider limit the gain. Okay. Then dia juga panggil this bridge as lead lag circuit. Okay. So kalau awak tengok dia punya frequency response ni ialah band pass with a narrow bandwidth. Okay. So if you teruskan dia punya ni dia boleh jadi oscillator lah. Okay. So usually in oscillator, we want to know the frequency of oscillation and the resonant frequency. Okay, dua benda ni lah selalunya kita akan kira FR dengan F naught. Okay, so this is the startup condition. This one you can relate to the startup condition for the general oscillator. But this one is for bridge AV atau AB dia sama dengan 3. ACL dia mesti sama dengan 1. Dia punya startup condition ni mesti sama. Okay. So, ni dia punya startup condition. Ni ada jenis letak zener, diode. Okay. Yang ni saya akan skip. Untuk phase shift oscillator pula, sama juga dia ada RC. Okay. Yang ni dia ada 3 pair. Okay. So, dia nak jadikan 180 degree total phase shift. Dia pairkan 3 RC. Okay. So, frequency of oscillation dia nak kira macam ni. Okay. Dia akan tanya awak soalan yang kira resonant frequency, frequency of oscillation. Okay. Itu RC. Okay. LC pula dia guna untuk higher frequency of oscillation lah. Okay. So, dia ada L dengan C. Combination L dengan C. Kalau awak tengok Z1, Z2, Z3. Z1, contoh call pits. Z1, L. Z2, C, C. Okay. And so on lah. Okay. So, you ganti nilai Z ni dengan C dengan L. So, dia akan jadi macam ni. Call pits, clap dengan Hartley. Sini kalau awak tengok LC ni. Yang ni memang untuk call pits lah. Then awak tengok ni lah. Derivation to calculate the C, C total, L and also the frequency, resonant frequency. Okay. So, ni explanation for each oscillator. Okay. Clap, Colpitts, Armstrong. Okay. Crystal control ni ialah most stable and accurate, but this one it's just for the theory. A crystal has natural frequency of resonance. They guna quartz material to have a certain frequency. So, depends on the material, type of material to get this certain frequency. And we can better understand the use of crystal in operation of oscillator by viewing the electrical equivalent. So, this is the crystal equivalent circuit. So, dia ada C dengan L dengan R. So, include all RLC. Okay, so since crystal have natural resonant frequency of 20 megahertz or less, generation of high frequency are attained by operating the crystal is what is called the overtone mode. So, dia overtone lah to multiple the frequency. Okay, so untuk this chapter, you have to know the startup condition. Sustain condition. Okay. Let me use the... Okay. Startup condition. Ni oscillator Oscillator is the feedback lah, oscillator. Nanti kita akan masuk kepada feedback. Relaxation oscillator pula. Okay, so you have to know the startup condition. Sustain condition with the diagram this one also with the diagram. Okay, and the rest is for your knowledge lah. Types of feedback oscillator. So, dia ada LC dengan RC lah. Okay. So, that's all for this chapter. So, I I think I will continue for the next chapter after this. Okay. Thank you very much for your attention.